just a few things. If anyone has a mobile telephone, if you can just make sure that it is on silent, please.
Thank you, everything.
Can you put it on the loudspeaker, please?
Yes. Very good. Thank you. I'll start again. Thank you all very much for coming to the meeting this evening. If anyone has a mobile telephone, you can please make sure that it is on silent. A few things I will mention. Firstly, many of you will know that we are shrining paper light committee meetings where possible. This committee, I'm looking at several people that have asked for a paper copy in front of me, but nevertheless, this committee is one that has been trying it, simply an efficient way of running business. But there are paper copies available for anyone who wants one. If anyone in the public hasn't got a paper copy and wanted one, they are very close to Santa Maria, is probably a good focal point to mention, just to leave it right on the table there. Thank you very much. If anyone requires one.
So just to flag something.
Yes, of course.
I am technically paralyzed, and I never asked for a copy. I did find some copies lying around the group room. So maybe we need to think about some copies and, you know, ensuring that members are given a copy printed, or at least some kind of consistency around the website. I'm not entirely sure about
We can address that later, but generally speaking, paper light committee. The other thing also, I've mentioned this several times, but I'll make a point to mention it, the meeting is recorded, so comments that are made by members, etc., can be heard remotely from outside of this venue. We have got quite a few people with phones and cameras and things like that recording. There's no issue with that, I'll just make that very clear. So if you want to record, of course, you can, as long as it doesn't sort of go in the way of anybody's coming to speak or anything like that. I don't expect that that's going to happen anyway, but there's no issue with anyone recording it in that way. If we look at the agenda items, first of all, minutes of the last meeting that were circulated, maybe a week.
I'd like to propose an amendment. I do understand in my recollection that the request asked for officers to provide alternative updates on the side, but asked for officers to provide ministry an update on the implementation of the protocol, including the number of individuals that have been placed in residence and cared, and that. But there was also a very specific point which was about enabling this item to return with a private update and continue to enable residents to be able to ask questions. I do believe that was a very, that effectively was a really strong point that was made, that obviously would come out with some additional information and that that would enable time for residents to be able to question things and then they need to know about this issue.
Thank you very much. Noted. As far as the last meeting is concerned, the minutes are concerned, and that is generally, residents would have a right to ask questions. You will know that some questions have been asked in any event, in a moment, whether or not that's formally within the minutes or not, nothing's changed as far as that's concerned. Residents have the ability to do that, and they're clearly hands off as we have questions that will be asked in our social hall.
So, you're saying that you don't think that point should be recorded in
the minutes? I'm not spending time discussing this in great detail when people have come to deal with delivery items on our agenda. This is something that potentially you could have raised with government prior to the meeting today. I clearly did not draft the minutes. If government felt around that, they would have done. I looked at government as to whether or not they feel that they have that record from the last occasion and seek to add it.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. So just referring to the last paragraph.
Sorry, can't hear you.
Sorry. Councillor, just referring to the last paragraph. It does ask for, it does refer to the committee agreeing that the report be brought back to the adults said by the committee. Is that what you meant?
So, yeah, so we're talking about the reasons for why the report will be brought to the next meeting of the Safeguard Committee. And the reason was to provide extra information, which is incorporated, and to enable the organisation, the individuals, the organisation, the individuals who had concerns about it to be able to explain their views and sort of strategy. There were two reasons for why we agreed collectively as a committee that this would be brought back.
Okay, we can record that as an update to the previous meeting under this 7 minutes.
And what wording will you be using?
In relation to what you asked, that wasn't a recommendation as such. That was part of the discussion.
Can I hear you?
Can you pick up this thing?
Yes, of course. In relation to what you're raising now, that wasn't a formal recommendation for this reform. That was something that was generally discussed, which, as I've stated, residents and indeed every organisation has the ability to ask a question upon in any event as to whether or not it's been added or not.
Well, there have been some changes since that last meeting. And I think it's a bit disingenuous to say that people are able to ask questions in any event when the council has restricted residents and campaigners and other people's ability to ask questions in relation to each item to choose. And that is the point that I'm making, which is that in June there was an assurance that was given that this issue would come to this committee, people would be able to ask questions on it, and information would be given. In goodwill, the committee agrees to that. We're here in September. Council has since asked a rule. That means that this group of people are not able to ask a question. And then there are two questions that really are in confrontation anyway, so in particular.
I'm not asking for the minutes to be amended in that regard. It's duly noted that there was a conversation that took place during submission by you and others on the last occasion in relation to the size of the back. That may have included, we don't need to surprise anything relating, but it may have included the fact that people can come and ask questions. Clearly, I also specified that people could. Someone has a phone, but I know they're looking to turn it off. You don't need to apologise, it's fine. I'm sure you'll turn it off. That's fine. We did mention on the last occasion that residents could also come and see me to discuss things or email me directly, things of that nature. Every item that was discussed at the meeting does not need to go within the minutes. I understand the reason as to why you're asking the question, because of a policy change in relation to our questions were asked by people. It seems improper in those circumstances, but what I would say is it doesn't need to be added formally in the minutes. It's noted that you said that people have the opportunity to ask questions in any event that will still be dealt with. And you will notice, of course, as I said earlier, Ms. Martin is one person I've seen today's admission to the building and she has asked a question. There's one example of someone who has asked a question and has the opportunity to do so. So if people have had that opportunity, I'm not discussing this any further.
We will not be agreeing in a minute unless there is a specific reference to the fact that many people will remember. Which was the reason that we were bringing this issue back for information and also for the options.
The government's office has suggested an amendment. The government's officer hasn't told you what amendment was suggested. Nothing's been agreed on suggesting that amendment needs to take place. I'm taking the vote on this as drafted. All in favour? It's four. Against? For my votes to carry the vote, this will agree. Thank you. Can I sign the record of them? Thank you. Moving on to agenda item two, absence of members.